When you have negative thoughts, your mind, your community, and everything will work to make this happen. You will attract people who are negative. Starting a business, starting a new endeavor, starting a new job, starting a new life, doing many of these different things brings on a lot of anxiety. And you're going to get a lot of negativity from many people that you know that are part of your circle. And you don't need to join the party, so to speak, where you become part of the negativity. One of the biggest problems that we have, and I think Dr. Benjamin E. May said this, it isn't the lack of aim, it's low aim. And what I mean by that is when you have a problem and you immediately go to the lowest common denominator or the worst things that can happen. Statistically, most people's fears are not borne out. So all of this negative movie reels that you have going on in your head, more than likely, it's not going to happen. We're about to get into that mindset game. There are many people who think negative thoughts every day, every hour, every situation. I'm going to give you a few examples. The car breaks down. There's not one thought that goes through a person's head. It's the car broke down. How much money is it going to cost me? Oh God, will I be able to get to work? There's a multitude of negative thoughts that are occurring in this person's mind from one event. Now, this is very, very important. One of the things you should do when something negative happens is you should immediately start to reframe the situation so you mentally don't freak out. Car's breaking down. He's like, okay, car's breaking down. We're going to figure out what it's going to be. We're going to handle this and I will have the money. Many of you don't speak to yourselves that way. Many of you go to the freak out moment because it's normal. It's what we're taught. You've had people who at one negative event will literally have a whole movie reel of bad outcomes. Now, this is why you don't ever want to have negative thoughts or even a negative thought. It sets in a chain of reaction of thousands of negative thoughts. What's going to happen is you're going to develop a negative vibe. Anytime something bad happens, you're automatically going to default to your negative vibe. This is going to happen, that's going to happen, and it's just not really going to happen. But due to the fact this is what you're feeding your subconscious mind is going to be predicated to making these bad outcomes become real bad outcomes. I used to be a speeder, and I used to constantly get pulled over. And this is what would happen. I would see a cop car, and then I wouldn't think it, but my behavior would change. And it was very funny because what I was doing was acting in a manner that was suspicious, even though I'm thinking like I'm trying to drive straight. I will tell you a jacked up story in a minute. I would actually alert them to my bad behavior and I would get pulled over. In 1 year, I got 3 tickets. One more, my license would have been suspended. And every time I saw a cop, fear would fill my heart. And then it would start programming my behavior to make what I didn't want to happen to happen. When I was poor, and I'm not proud of this, but I drove a year without insurance. I suggest you don't do this. And how did I drive like a year without insurance? I drove for everyone else on the road. I did not drive for myself. I drove in a very defensive manner. If I saw people acting crazy, I would not pass them because I couldn't risk getting a ticket and pulled over for speeding. I would slow down and get way behind them. Stop sign, I would start slowing down. I drove like Miss Daisy. Never got pulled over, never alerted a cop because my desire was I had to make money for my family, so I could not have money going out for tickets and court costs and jail. I didn't realize that I had the power to change these outcomes. One time I was going to see a friend in DC. I was young, I was full of energy. I left Atlanta, Georgia and went to DC and I had a Nissan Stanza and I was doing about 105. Most of the way, because that's as fast as it was going. If it could have gone faster, I would have been faster. I rocked a North Carolina cop car. And this is when they had adopted to these gold Mustangs. So you didn't know it was a cop until it was too late and you were right on him. Zoom! And I know I rocked him. And I was like, if I'm going to get caught, I'm going to really be doing some speed. So I went up to 107, 108, just kept going, and kept looking. Never got pulled over. Being in the zone, and I didn't understand any of this stuff. And the older you become and you start looking back, you can start connecting the dots and start to see how your mental environment sets up your physical environment. And I was in such a state of mind, I didn't care if I got pulled over. I wasn't scared. My heart didn't start beating. I was like, oh, well, I'm gonna get pulled over. One of the things that I have to guard myself against on Facebook is I'm very vocal. I state my mind. I state my opinions in a very unapologetic way. This actually attracts negative people. This attracts people who have opposing views. And some of these folks have literally perpetrated violence on me because they didn't like what I was saying. They didn't like my thought process. Part of the issue is that we've come into a world where people do not appreciate perspective. And when I get to the money frame, I'll be talking very much about perspective. And when you have these negative thoughts and you draw these negative people, you create a negative theme for yourself and your life. I'm going to venture here. Nick Cannon, he said something recently. You can Google it. We're not going to get into it. But because he set off this controversy, people have lost their minds because I started to see how many people who were already pre-orientated to this negative theme. And it was just amazing because people got very defensive. People took sides. And I was like, wow. When you have negative thoughts, you're programmed for negativity. You're programmed not to look outside yourself. You're programmed not to even do research. Because if anyone did any research on some of the things that Nick said, they would see that he was being very, very hypocritical. This is how people become programmed. And the negative programming and the negative themes and the negative frames, it becomes a habit. And then you have this situation where someone could trigger you because you are in the habit of negativity. There are many men and women out there who's like, I can't find anyone. I'm just comfortable being alone. These people have set the negative frame. I'm not going to find anyone, so I'll just go it alone, and I will just prepare myself to be alone. They have succumbed to the negative frame. So all of this stuff has started with literally one negative thought. That's it. All it takes is one negative thought. Now, I talk a lot of junk, and I come down on people, and this is one of the reasons that I slam people in the comments. I've been doing YouTube for many years, and I have seen all it takes is the right type of negative comment, and then people will pile on, because many people who are negative seek out the negative community. They don't want to learn anything. They don't want to adapt an opposing viewpoint. They want to solidify what they're thinking, even though it's negative. Even though it doesn't make them any money, even though it is foolish to talk about for 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 hours, they have dug in because this is all they have. Once again, completing the negative frame. If people were to come outside of their frames, their echo chambers, and their negativity, they will see that many, many possibilities and many, many doors are opening up. I'm going to do a live stream or a video about a conversation that I had with a client. After 3 years, the client is now in a position to get 7-figure loans. If the things that didn't happen in the two plus years ago didn't happen, the decisions that didn't happen, the money that was spent, we wouldn't be in that position today. And this kind of gets into what the heart of negativity is. When you become exceptional in thought, you'd stir up a lot of negative energy because what people see is that you've now become dissimilar from them. Is there something about you that is different? And we're taught, and it's part of our primal DNA, to attack and destroy what is different. So then you've created this positive vibe, you've created this positive frame, then all of a sudden haters, people who will surprise you are coming out of nowhere. They're attacking you because now you're no longer a mirror. As long as you're a mirror, you will not be attacked because they'll look at you and they'll see themselves and they'll see themselves in a positive light. Once you make just a small change in who you are, that mirror is no longer there. That mirror is positive mirror is no longer there. Instead of looking at themselves, they're actually seeing you. And they're seeing what's wrong with themselves or what they perceive to be wrong with themselves. And then they go on the attack mode. Once again, you can be positive. You can be in a positive frame and you will be attacked. And this is good. The more people that attack you, the greater the positive frame that you're creating. If you don't have people who are attacking you, who are coming after you, then you've not really created a better frame for yourself. The stronger the positive frame is, the stronger and the more ardent that these people will come after you. They will say your name in vain. They will swear at you. They will cuss at you. And some of this will be very surprising, because usually the people who will be the worst at this type of behavior will be the people who are closest to you. It'll be very rare that a stranger will come out and say something. It'll be someone who's either a fan, a relative, or a close friend. Someone who feels they know you and they feel they know enough about you to attack you because you're creating a vacuum. Once that positive image in the mirror is gone, and then you replace this image with stuff they're not doing, so they perceive themselves to be messed up, there creates a vacuum. In this vacuum, two things are going to fill it: hate or love. And typically, most people, due to the negative frames, don't really believe in love, don't have love, or never really felt love. So the only thing that could enter that vacuum is negativity. That's it. And part of this is, if you no longer ever think of negative thoughts, it gives you the mental arsenal, the mental energy to refute that versus succumb to it. The principles of never having a negative thought are so powerful and they're so strong, but there is an apprenticeship, or what I like to call the gauntlet. There's going to be this rough period of a year, maybe 2 or 3 years, where people are going to come after you. You're going to feel some kind of way. And what's happening is you are mentally adjusting. That's what's happening. You're becoming stronger. You're becoming braver. You're making a certain type of decision for your life. And all of a sudden, you'll look at these people and they will seem so small. I have a ton of haters. I have categories for my haters. There's the fake-ass friend. There's the fake-ass fan. There's the kiss, 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 stab person. It's just wild, because people will invest more energy into negativity and hate than they will be into investing in positive things because of the gauntlet. Being positive, creating a positive frame, you're going to catch so much hell during that period that many people are just like, I'm not going to do this, which comes back to responsibility. Once you know these principles, once you understand how the universe works, you are never, ever going to have a negative thought. Or if you do, you're going to self-talk your way out of it so quick, you're going to say, okay, we're going the wrong way. I need to talk myself off the ledge. This is what we're going to do. This is how we're going to do it. We're going to make moves. And this is how statistically I have gotten a little better each year. And that's very, very important. You don't have to make sweeping 180 degree change, 90 degrees of change. Seriously, if you increase yourself 5 to 10% per year, that's plenty. That's enough to make you a multimillionaire. That's enough to give you the energy to have the life you want. You don't have to radically change who you are. You just have to radically change certain aspects of your personality. And once you figure that out, you won't even want to have negative thoughts. You won't even want to hang around negative people, because there are some YouTubers that I've talked to, I'm not going to say their names, they're going through the gauntlet with their YouTube careers right now, making videos, and people really wasn't messing with them. No one was really causing any problems. They were like, hey, I like you, you're cool. Then all of a sudden, they took a stance. And they started saying stuff that was very unpopular. It was true, but it was unpopular. Then all of a sudden, they come out with the pitchforks. They come out with the torches. They come out with the javelins. Some people are locked and loaded with the shotgun because what you're saying disturbs their negative frame so much that they are moved to violence and hate on you. That's a good thing, because once you get through this gauntlet, it evens out. You know how to deal with these people. You become mentally much tougher than you used to be. And this mental toughness gives you the mental energy to go to the next level, and then to go to the next level, and to go to the next level. I've seen some people grow. And this is the thing. It takes time to grow. It takes time to reprogram yourself. But so many people are like, I gotta have it now. I need to make these changes in a few weeks. I need to make these changes in a few months. We're talking a 2 to 5 year journey for the mental change, for the money to increase, for the business to increase. And this is something else too. I was talking to my client and we're going to get into it. Once you get to a certain level mentally, you can never go back. You just can't. This whole notion of, I actually saw this comment today. It's like, if I lost everything, I have the knowledge to get it all back. That is poverty thinking. Yes, it is. Because once you learn certain laws of the universe, you're never, ever going back. You're never, ever going to be poor. It's just not going to happen. Once you experience these things, it's like, I'm not going back to the boarding house. I use that as a carrot to keep myself going, but I am never, ever going back to that boarding house. And I can tell you why. One, I surround myself with good people. Very important. Two, I am not alone. When I was in that boarding house, I was alone. Number three, I make good, sound economic decisions. It's just not going to happen. But that's a little fear I use to keep myself motivated, because if you slip, if you get really complacent, you could possibly end up there. But it ain't going to ever happen. We'll even get into more of that here at Money, Income, and Profit, because once you build a certain economic base, there is no such thing as going back. There's no such thing as being poor. I'll give you a few examples. Every former NBA player that had some level of fame or played, you know, 7, 8, 12 seasons, they can always make money. Charles Barkley can just like, hey, I'm going to be somewhere, sign autograph. Bam, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, $6,000 in a day. Charles Oakley, he lives here. Same thing. And once you reach that level, there's so many opportunities available to you because you have changed your money frame. You know, you may not be making millions of dollars. I'll give you a good example. Greg McElroy, he used to be a quarterback for University of Alabama. He played well enough to win at Alabama, won the national championship. He parlayed that into a backup position. And then now he's a sportscaster, and I already see where he's going. He's going to have seven-figure paychecks for the next 10, 15, 20 years. He's going to make more money as a broadcaster than he ever did playing football. I'm going to say that again, because a lot of people think he's going to make more money as a broadcaster than he did playing football. Another one, Ron Gant. Look him up. He used to play for the Atlanta Braves. He matriculated himself to now he's on Good Day Atlanta. Athletes and people who have really changed their mental and money frames understand the game, and they're never going back to poverty. Some people, in the case of Dave Bing, who used to play for the Detroit Pistons, he actually started a business, unfortunately hit upon hard times, but he was making way more money as a business owner than he ever did playing basketball. True story. I actually was in the military with his granddaughter, Lori Bing. And this is how I knew his story. So there's so many things that you can do, but you got to stop being negative. You got to stop looking for the angle. You got to start to be more objective and clear with what your intentions are. And this is very, very important. A few years ago, I was talking about living a life of design and intent. Most people don't have design nor intent for their lives. They're just living. That's it. There's no plan. There's no grand trajectory. They're just trying to survive, and that's what their mental environment, their subconscious mind is going to give them. Mere survival. If you want to mentally ball out, do so, because sooner or later you will physically ball out. So for those of you who need a little help, below in the two comments is how to get your basic financial education. That's the first comment. And the second comment are some goodies to accelerate this process. Plus, there's a lot more coming this year. So whatever you spend, you don't have to spend again. What it means is when I introduce something else, if you bought the basic financial education package, that will be taken off. Since I know who you are, you'll get an email with a certain coupon code so you can get into the next thing minus the money you already spent. How cool is that? So with that, I'll see you guys in the next video.